Kitchen. Today we're making honey mustard dipping sauce. Now you can use that as a dipping sauce for chicken, like chicken tenders, or you can use some other kind of meat if you want to. You can actually use it as a salad dressing. Some of you like to have a green leafy salad with honey mustard dressing on top, and I haven't made that yet, so here goes. We need a small bowl. This is kind of a small to medium sized bowl. We're going to put some mayonnaise in. This is 3/4 cup of mayonnaise. We just slide that in there. And next comes mustard. And this is the yellow prepared mustard. If you want to use Dijon, that's okay, or some other fancy variety would be okay. 1/4 cup. But I'm using the yellow prepared mustard. And then we're going to put in some honey. Since it's honey mustard, we're going to match the amount of mustard with the amount of honey, 1/4 cup. And that can be any type of honey that you can find in your grocery store. There are different types, but it doesn't have to be any one specific type. 1/4 cup. And then we have 1/4 cup of grated onion. It's minced very fine. So actually I got out the electric kitchen chopper and did this because I didn't want to risk having bits that were very large. So these are very fine pieces of onion. And this kind of reminds me at this point, I do have a dipping sauce for chicken in Betty's kitchen already, and it's called chicken dipping sauce. So if you want to look that up, it's a lot different from this one and you might enjoy it. And then from here we're just going to shake in a little bit of hot sauce, not too much, about like that, and then a little bit of Worcestershire sauce, not too much, probably a little more than you do of hot sauce, and then here is a pinch of celery seeds. So put that in. And we have all of our ingredients here, so we're just going to stir these around. So when you get it to the point where you think everything is blended pretty well, you could just leave it in here for serving if you wanted to. If you're doing something a little fancier, then you might want to place it in its serving container right now and then cover it and refrigerate it until serving time. So I'm going to pour this into a little white bowl. I'm going to take a little bite of it, just test it out. Of course, it's better after it sits for a while. So when I get it out of the refrigerator after it's had maybe 4 hours or 8 hours to sit, then it's going to be absolutely scrumptious. Really good. You don't expect something that's hot and spicy and normally is served as a dip rather than just eating it by the spoon. You don't expect that to taste that good, but this is really good enough to eat by the spoon. I think you'll like it.